I'm Clayton Vaughn, and you're watching Explore Tulsa.
Hello, and welcome to another Explore Tulsa. This week, we start the show with the folks giving Tulsa an insider's look at the mayor's office.
Then we meet the women, helping women realize their full potential.
Followed by a few dream homes that won't cost you the shirt off your back.
Plus, the real jewel of Lewis.
Hi, I'm Stevie Fernandez.
And I'm Trish Whitmer. It's good to have you back with us for this week's Explore Tulsa.
You know, Trish, I was up at the mayor's office this week giving a few ideas on how to make Tulsa more hip.
Really? Don't you mean you and the Explore Tulsa crew were at the mayor's office? You know, doing a story on the mayor's new communication production team?
That too, but I was also convincing him that he should help bring an NFL franchise to Tulsa.
Oh yeah, there you go. That would solve all of Tulsa's problems.
I know, right? It's like it's almost too simple.
Showing up to work each day is just a small piece of life's puzzle for three very special City of Tulsa employees nominated for a very special award.
Here at City Hall, there are amazing things happening every day. And as a Tulsa citizen, I didn't really know what happened in the mayor's office, but now I'm up here with the camera and I'm able to show citizens what's going on. There's a lot of hard work going on here. And that doesn't always come across on the 5 o'clock news.
So here it is, 2013, and it's time for citizens to decide how to drive into the future.
I wanted to have some people in our staff, if I could, that we could use television as a very positive medium to get information out. I knew we had a television channel, or access to one, but I also wanted to do more than just show meetings. I was able to hire a press secretary, Lloyd Wright, that had a very significant amount of television experience in his background, as well as journalism experience in his background. I told him, I said, I want to set our sail with television production to be able to tell our story in a very positive way, not just a bunch of smoke, but tell the truth, but to focus on the things that many times people really don't see, understand, or we in Tulsa take for granted that others might not be aware of.
New Solutions is the city's new hauler for trash and recycling collection.
Yeah, Beth and I worked together for about 4 to 5 years, I believe it was, at Channel 2. And she was my favorite reporter to work with. And that is because not only is she a great person, but we fed off of each other well. You know, she knew how I shot video and I knew how she would write the scripts. So, you know, we really never had to tell each other, hey, make sure you get this, or hey, make sure you write that. We just always knew what each other was going to do.
And so I try to take my storytelling abilities to make them a little bit more interesting to the average Joe. I always kind of ask myself, how would I explain this story to my grandmother? And so I take out all the big words like infrastructure and codes and ordinance and things like that, and just try to make it a little bit more conversational. We also have to talk about, you know, some of the problems that our city deals with every day, one of which is our brownfield sites. We have some sites that we could really use the money from the federal government to help clean up so we could develop them. We showed that video to some EPA officials who came to meet the mayor one day, and those government officials asked if they could have my video and take it around and show other cities in the country what Tulsa is doing.
Trespassers have made their mark on the old Evans Fintu building over the years, but city leaders still see its potential.
Each of them have a mixture of talents that I think is very important for this type of job. Besides being good journalists, they also edit well, they photograph well. They spend a lot of time traveling around with us and seeing things, and then they can conceptualize along with Lloyd, hey, that's a good idea, let's tell this story.
Getting the job done. Keeping residents informed.
We're probably doing about 900 homes a day.
Keeping Tulsa beautiful.
I love that we can tell stories through video. People nowadays want to see video, they want to see pictures, they don't want to just read something, they want to visualize it. And I love that we're able to do that on a daily basis here. I love that.
I just fell in love with Tulsa 6 years ago, and that was right when ground was breaking on the BOK Center. And I've sort of witnessed all of the excitement take off in downtown Tulsa. To be brought into the mayor's office and welcomed the way it was such a great feeling. And everyone who works up here has the same passion for our city. They all love Tulsa. They all want to see it succeed. And Mayor's a pretty positive guy. I'm sure you've picked up on that. But when you go from being a reporter to telling stories about the mayor to working for the mayor and sort of seeing his passion and all the meetings he shows up to and all of the hard work he puts into it, sort of makes you want to work that much harder for the good of the city.
Beth and Brian really are doing some great work.
Plus, it's very forward-thinking of the mayor's office to be using video in a way that allows us as citizens to be able to easily see and understand much of what goes on each and every day in our fair city.
Search for City of Tulsa on YouTube and you can find all of Beth and Brian's work.
Just ahead, we're going to meet a woman who's been leading a charge that has meant a brighter future for many Tulsa women.
And it's just the beginning next with Janice Jones.
You think it's possible that we could watch the entire segment and not just the beginning?
Stick around. There's more Explore Tulsa next.
Shopping for authentic Native American gifts has never been easier. Whether you're looking for jewelry, art, or official Cherokee Nation apparel and books, you're sure to find all the perfect items in one place. Cherokee Nation Gift Shops. With 8 convenient retail locations or shop online at CherokeeGiftShop.com. And don't miss our official Cherokee OU and OSU merchandise. Cherokee Nation Gift Shop. Convenient, affordable, authentic.
I'm carbon dating this carpet.
When you visit Video Revolution at 71st and Lewis, you won't find a bunch of money spent on fancy extras. That way, Video Rev can pass huge savings to customers every day.
Like the Samsung 46-inch LED 1080p smart TV for only $649.
Or this Sony 55-inch 1080p LED with built-in Wi-Fi and 3D Ready for only $14.99.
So bring in your dinosaur and trade up today.
Video Revolution, located on the northwest corner of 71st and Lewis.
For a taste of Italy in Tulsa, may we recommend Tiamo. For 20 years, Tulsa diners have come to Tiamo for the very best in authentic Italian and Mediterranean dishes. With a dining room perfectly suited for single diners or groups and an incomparable menu, it's easy to see why Tiamo has been voted best Italian restaurant in Tulsa. Tiamo now with two locations, 61st and Sheridan, and our new downtown location on the northeast corner of 3rd and Cheyenne. Tiamo, fine dining at an affordable price.
I'm Erin Edwards.
And I'm Junianne Wakely.
We're from the Vintage Pearl.
And you're watching Explore Tulsa.
Hello, and welcome back for more Explore Tulsa.
We love it when we find people for our show that are doing more than just making a living while doing their job.
Especially people like Janice Jones, who makes a living making a life for others to live.
For 13 years, I was married to a crack cocaine addict. Knowing where I am today and knowing what could have happened has given me a positive outlook on the people who hurt me. And in that, I go into the prisons, I go into the jails, and I help women who are caught up in a cycle that they have no idea about.
Well, I got incarcerated in April of 2009. I met Janice Jones, the executive director, in July of 2010. At the time that I met her, I was in a treatment program. I'm in recovery from 23 years of methamphetamine addiction and a childhood of trauma, so I was a couple years sober. So when I met Janice and I became a part of her program, just the beginning, I started to get discipled and I started to recognize that she was giving me something that I wasn't getting through the maybe the medical treatment side, and that was, how do I find my purpose?
One of the things we do is trauma care. Trauma care is where you'll go back to the beginning, wherever that is, as far back as you can remember, and it's in stages, it's a process to help you recognize where it is and how you got to be in that place. Once we identify, we work through those issues. And we go deeper, and we go as deep as we can go. And in those processes, there are people there to help mentor them through the process. See, it's not the drug addiction that's the problem. It's the trauma that's the problem. I had to get out of my own trauma in order to get to the place of helping other women. And it's not just helping them. We here at Just the Beginning Incorporated want women to not only be the business owners they're supposed to be the moms they're supposed to be, the successful wife they're supposed to be. We want them to be the full, whole person. And that's what we do here. To pull them out of the cycle is a critical part of what we do.
When I was in the middle of addiction, I had no idea. I felt most of the time like I didn't even deserve to breathe. And I literally had no idea who I was because I started using at the age of 14. And it was through this discipleship process that I began to recognize, you know, Kimberly is her own person. She has a purpose in her own life that she can fulfill. She's not here just to supply needs for other people or to mold herself into whatever setting there is that she's in the moment. And it's so hard to describe what that feels like in words, but this is the exact opposite. So now it's hopeful.
The graduations are Turley graduation. They have a 100-hour program, and Just the Beginning helps facilitate that program. And we facilitate that program through teaching on codependency, which is a place that I can relate to because I was there. After the 100-hour course, these particular women, anywhere from 20 to 25, they graduate the program. And it's a really exciting time. A lot of those women have never had any kind of celebration of who they are or an accomplishment. So it's really, really exciting.
Right now we're doing it out of my home, which is amazing, but it's getting small fast. So we have a class of 14. So right now we're looking for a location. You know, what kind of location can we move into? Because the second wave of women are coming. We've already got several women lined up for the next wave. So we're gonna have all of a sudden 30 women that we're gonna be teaching in a classroom, providing resources for, getting in-depth conversations with them about their trauma care. They need clothing. They need support in regards to like hygiene items. They don't have these things. They're coming either out of addiction, they're in between their case if it's a legal situation. So they're kind of not wanting to go back to the world. So how do we do that? You know, I want to provide them resources. Eventually we want to provide them some housing options. Most importantly, want to get them employed. Employment is purpose, and that's what helped me a lot in my own personal recovery as I became employed. We need communities to know. We need businesses in our communities to know. It's okay if someone has a felony conviction to go ahead and employ them and see if you can't give them an opportunity to rebuild their lives.
When women lose their sense of identity, which some of them have never had, and they gain it, it's a process of new living. That's why the name of the program is Just the Beginning.
Just the Beginning is just that, a fresh start to a whole new world.
Janice and her entire crew are doing some amazing work. If you would like to find out more, or maybe you want to help out too, visit justthebeginninginc.org.
Next up, we meet a guy that also works hard to make dreams come true.
That's right, Trish. Mike Harrison of Lifeway Homes takes a scary out of home buying, and we'll visit him next when Explore Tulsa continues.
Frustrated with your computer's performance? Looking to upgrade or repair the one you have? RK Computers at 5649 South Mingo in Tulsa has the solution. RK Computers sells new computers, used computers, and provides network installation and support. Keep your system running at its top performance. We offer the highest trade-in values and below market prices on late model desktop computers, laptops, network equipment, workstations, and monitors. Stop in or call us. Our expert technical staff will be glad to assist you. The Royal Dragon at 51st and Memorial in the Fontana Shopping Center is celebrating their 35th anniversary, and you're invited. The Royal Dragon has been and still is Tulsa's tradition to meet family and friends for a wonderful meal. It's also home of the all-day buffet. A full menu is available if you prefer. When it comes to planning holiday events, weddings, receptions, birthdays, or an anniversary, the Royal Dragon has private rooms where you can use the entire restaurant.
Hi, I'm Mike Harrison, and I'm the owner of Lifeway Homes, and you're watching Explore Tulsa.
It's great to have you still with us for more Explore Tulsa.
Trish, you recently bought a new home, right?
That's right, Stevie, I did. And it's been a real learning process, doing all the little things to make it just right before moving in.
That's why, for me, I just want a place that has that new home smell. One I could just move right in and not have to worry about a thing.
Like the prefab homes you find at Lifeway Homes?
Hey, now why didn't I think of that?
I am from the Tulsa area. I grew up in Claremore, Oklahoma. And when I went off to college, I had a couple of friends of mine that have been in the manufactured housing industry. Back then we called it the mobile home business. And I started working at a mobile home dealership in the summers between semesters, and began to just move into this line of business. As soon as I got out of college, I came back to Tulsa and went to work with those two friends, and we worked a lot of years, and this is really the only business I've ever been in. Back then it was considerably different. Mostly we were just becoming larger homes. Even some of the double wides that were available at that point in time were in the 1500, 1600 square foot range, and now, like this home we're standing in, it's 2300 square foot, and we get much bigger than that if people need to. Back then it was probably a little more similar to what you would think of as a starter home or a lake home or a retirement home. But now, you know, really this is a great alternative to just site-built construction or buying an existing site-built home. A lot of the times the folks are really, you know, they come in, well, I just need a repo, or I just need an old used house, and you know, their expectation level is way down here, and they just don't realize what we have available to, you know, for $600 to $700 a month, they can get a really, really nice home. And then we still have starter homes in the 250 to 350 range. These homes are built to such a high code. We can take these to the highest northern states, and they're very well insulated. The cabinetry is now the same as what you'd get in site-built construction, and the final finish, you know, you see behind me here, we've got ceramic tiles and inlaid rock and just regular tape and textured finished sheetrock. So really we're just like a site-built home in many ways. It's been really exciting. We just kind of had a journey in the last couple of years, and we've opened up a couple of sales centers in the north, one in North Dakota and one in Montana, and those have both been a wonderful addition to what we've got going on. And then we have the two sales centers here in Tulsa. We have a Mayanam Homes, and then the original name is our Lifeway Homes sales center. So it's been a wonderful progression over the last couple of years to go from just the single lot to what we've got going on right now. I enjoy people, and this is a people job. So if I can visit with folks all day long, that's my perfect job. And so that was probably the real attraction. And I will tell you, when people buy a home from you, I don't know how you could really ever get more close to someone. You know everything that's going on in their life, from family things that are going on to how could we help them in a financial way put this thing together. So it's a fun way to really get to know people in person. We actually just sold a home up into Canada. We're working on some Canadian business. We've got some business way down in South Texas, so we're almost top to bottom of the United States. And I get to travel some in that. It's mostly work, but I was just kiddingly talking to my kids the other day and my wife, and I said, you know, if I could live anywhere else or anywhere in the United States, you know, I think I'd just pick Claremore, Oklahoma. So that's kind of how I feel. I just love it here. You know, this is home, and this is where I want to keep my roots.
Now I know prefab and mobile homes sometimes get a bad rap, but with all the modern conveniences Lifeway Homes has to offer, I don't see how you could go wrong.
Plus, Mike and his staff are all about helping people first. Visit lifewayhomes.net to learn more.
You know, Trish, maybe not everybody's in the market to buy a house. Maybe this week, just maybe, folks are a little more interested in buying jewelry.
Now you're talking my language, and I have just the place in mind. The Vintage Pearl is next when Explore Tulsa continues.
Since 1964, Guitar House of Tulsa is the player's choice. We provide excellent customer service and the best selection on guitars, basses, mandolins, banjos, ukuleles, and amplifiers in Tulsa. Check out the latest products from PRS, Martin, Taylor, Spector, Charvel, Takamine, Alvarez, Mesa Boogie, Orange, and many more. Open Monday through Saturday. Ask about our string instrument repair, 0% interest financing, and private lessons with the best instructions in Tulsa. Guitar House of Tulsa. We'll keep you strumming along.
Have you noticed your vision seeming a little narrowed and blurry?
Then you may be suffering from SDTV.
Let the LED experts at Video Revolution help you see what you've been missing.
Like the Samsung 1080p 50-inch LED for only $749.
Or this Sony 60-inch 1080p LED for only $14.99.
Video Revolution at 71st and Lewis can help you find the perfect HD.
And 3D prescription to custom fit your home entertainment needs.
Be sure and stop in next week when we meet RSU's newest TV GM, Royal Ailes.
Well, that's all the time we have for you on this week's show. But special thanks to Mayor Bartlett, Beth Hawkins, and Brian Nutt for giving us all the inside scoop to what's going on with T-Town.
Thanks, too, to Janice Jones and her team of hardworking folks doing so many great things with just the beginning. And thanks to Mike Harrison for hooking Tulsa up with some really beautiful homes. Remember, I need that fireplace and the jacuzzi tub, all for my master.
Plus, thanks to Aaron Edwards, June Ann Wakely, and all the folks making the Vintage Pearl such a fun place to shop.
Remember, if you miss any of the show, you can always catch us at ExploreTulsaChannel.com.
As always, each week we feature the people, places, and attractions that make us proud to call Tulsa our home.
Hey, don't forget to like us on Facebook. Share with us someone you think Tulsa should know more about. Plus, remember, Explore Tulsa is always brought to you by Video Revolution, located on the northwest corner of 71st and Lewis.
If you're looking for home audio, home video, HD TVs,
or you just want to learn how to make your iPhone, iPad, or other smart device run your entire entertainment system,
please stop by and say hello to Ron and all the guys for your home entertainment needs. And we'll see you next week right here on Explore Tulsa.